Observational learning. We do a lot of our learning not through direct reinforcement, not through direct punishment, not through direct exposure to stimuli that impinge upon us physically, but on watching other people, right? We're watching stuff and we're learning because we're a very sophisticated species. Not all species can watch and learn. It looks like apes can do this. Monkeys can do this. To some degree, some other animals. But how many people, by show of hands, know how to rob a bank? Raise your hand if you know how to rob a bank. There you go. All you other people? Seriously? You don't know how to rob a bank. You don't have any idea how to rob a bank. I didn't ask you, are you going to rob a bank? I said, do you know how to rob a bank? Now, how many people know how to rob a bank, but wouldn't do it? You really don't know how to rob a bank? Or you just don't want to raise your hand?
Successfully rob a bank?
Well, here's the thing, right? You take in a pretend gun, right? You take in a note. You say, give me all the money. That's how you do it, right? You've seen a movie, right? Have you not seen movies on bank robbery, right? I didn't say you were going to do it. I said you know how to do it. In other words, we know how to do lots of things, maybe successfully or unsuccessfully, right, that we don't actually do. And this was discovered by Bandura, Albert Bandura, during his Bobo doll experiment. His Bobo doll experiment was this. He had preschool kids watch models televised, right? They recorded adult models beating up a Bobo doll. Bobo doll's like an old schmoo. It's got a weight at the bottom. It's a little blow-up doll. It's about this high. You whack it, it falls over, it pops right back up. That's a Bobo doll. Huh?
Was a Bobo a clown?
Bobo could look like a clown. Yeah, I've got a picture of the original Bobo doll, and it does look like a clown. Anyway, what they thought back in the day was boys are naturally aggressive. Girls just aren't naturally aggressive. Girls, sugar and spice and all the things nice. You might have a crazy one every now and then, but they just can't do that. They're not capable of aggression. So what Bandura did was he set up some experimental conditions where he showed adults beating up on the Bobo doll. Boom, boom, and they would say things like pow, kick, and they sit on them and they do all these very specific behaviors. And then he would ask the kids to show me the behavior you saw in the video, right? And there are a lot of different variations on this, but the upshot is this. Initially, you ask the boys that, and they would do what? Bam, kick, pow, and they'd do exactly what they saw in a lot of it without any prompting. The girls would be like, right? Because... And you were like, well, see, they just don't do it. But then he offered a reward incentive, right? So then he showed models, and he has a lot of different variations on this, but if they were offered juice and cookies and stickers, all of a sudden these girls are like, bam, bam, pow, kick them, sock them. Cookie, please. Right? So it wasn't that they couldn't do it, right? It was that they had been socialized. What happens when girls in the 50s and all the times up to that point started acting aggressive? Girls don't do that. They got punishment for doing that. Boys, when they act aggressive, what? Oh, man, take that out on the field, buddy. That's right. You want to stick it to them. You got to be a tough guy. You got to be a macho man, right? So they got actual reinforcement for certain kinds of aggression, where girls got punishment for aggression. And what Bandura showed was it's not a sex difference, genetic sex difference, where men are wired to be aggressive and women are wired not to be aggressive. It's observational learning. And this is the thing you want to know for your test. Attention is required. Maybe you saw a bank robber moving, but you didn't pay attention. If you didn't pay attention, you couldn't know how to do it because you might be able to logically conclude how you would do it, but if you didn't see it, you can't learn it, right? If you didn't hear it, you couldn't learn it. So the observation has to occur with attention. Then you've got to be able to remember it. Mental retention has to occur. So you might have seen something as a kid and then forgotten about it. And that way, you learned it, but you kind of unlearned it. Reproduction must be possible. You must be able to do the behavior before we would see the behavior. And then there must be a motivation to exist. And that's what he found. The girls just didn't have a motivation to do the aggressive behavior. In fact, they had a motivation not to do the aggressive behavior, to be consistent with their own views of self and their prior learning history, which says that you get punished if you behave. So let me pull this up real quick, just for your deeper learning. They don't need it, but you might want it. Those who left being they. So some learning is latent. It has occurred, but it remains undemonstrated. And we have that all the time in our lives. There's all kinds of things we've learned that we haven't done. So the girls had learned aggression, but they didn't demonstrate aggression. They watched it, so they paid attention. They remembered how to do it. They could do it, but then they wouldn't do it, because there was no external incentive or any learning history that would encourage that behavior in that circumstance. When they changed the contingency, they got different behavior. And I use an example of my son where, when he was really little, he used to watch his sister do the dishes. And there's a 12-year difference between them, right? She hated doing dishes, but he loved her, and so he wanted to do dishes, right? So he paid attention. He could remember how. But you don't let a five-year-old do the dishes, do you? Right? Because they're going to break them. So he couldn't really do it. He couldn't put the dishes up. He couldn't hold on to them without dropping them. So we didn't let him do the dishes, but he pretended to do the dishes. So he understood the concept. Well, years go by. She's gone. He's there. He reaches that age. I say, guess what? It's time to do the dishes. And then he says what? I don't know how to do the dishes. I don't want to do the dishes. I don't know how to do the dishes. And I bet, well, I know you've seen it. I know you remembered it. And now I know you can do it. And if you don't do it, I'm going to remove some of your privileges. If you do it, you'll get to keep your privileges and you'll have my appreciation. And all of a sudden, dishwashing happens. Right? And so what we have is a change in motivation where the latent learn is now manifest, where what we're really looking at is vicarious reinforcement and punishment. You can also learn by watching other people be punished, right? You don't rob a bank, no matter how many heist pictures you've seen, right? You see people rob a bank, you know how, but you don't have the motivation, because what do you see? They usually get caught and killed or punished, right? So you don't have to actually go out and try robbing a bank and getting caught and put in prison to know not to do it. You see other people punished and learn not to do it. Or you see other people rewarded for things and learn to do it. And that's it for this test, y'all. I appreciate very much you taking the time to hang out with me a few more minutes. It was about 20 more, and I thank you. Y'all have a great spring break. Knock out that test when you get back.